In this video, I'm going to show you how to discover unmanaged devices by using Microsoft Defender for Endpoint. And I'm not just referring to endpoints like laptops, workstations, and servers. Network devices, like routers, can also be unmanaged. In fact, our definition of an unmanaged device is an endpoint on your network not onboarded to, or a network device not assessed in, our XDR solution. Attackers are more likely to compromise unmanaged devices, and by doing so, threaten your network. So, Defender for Endpoint helps you discover these network devices and endpoints so you can assess and protect them. We'll start by using Defender for Endpoint to discover and identify every unmanaged endpoint and network device on your corporate network. What previously unseen devices exist on your network, and what operating system version are they running? Once we know that information, we can compare the results to known vulnerabilities to assess them and help you onboard them. We use a distributed sensor architecture to discover endpoints. This architecture uses Defender for Endpoint on managed endpoints to see what devices are around them. It requires no effort, no deployment, no network configuration, maintenance, or security appliances either. It provides immediate value with almost zero effort. For network devices, we use targeted assessment. Since we can't install agents on these devices, we must take an agentless approach. And that approach is a remote, authenticated network scan. In this case, you choose a few managed endpoints to scan neighboring network devices by using SNMP. I'll come back to this later. You configure endpoint discovery in Settings, Device Discovery. On this page, you'll notice two discovery modes, Basic and Standard Discovery. With Basic Discovery, all onboarded endpoints will be passive sensors. That is, they're just listening to network traffic and reporting what they hear back to Defender for Endpoint. They find unmanaged devices, but the information they get is limited. Standard Discovery builds on that by actively probing endpoints. While Standard Discovery doesn't find any more devices than Basic Discovery, it does identify more information about them. These richer details include their host names and operating system versions. The default discovery mode is Standard Discovery, and we recommend that you leave it that way. It's not intrusive on targeted devices, so there's no reason to change it. In fact, we've done a lot of testing to ensure that we won't negatively impact any devices we probe. If you want to control which devices can perform Standard Discovery, use Tags to scope it. Choose Select Tags, followed by Edit Selected Tags, to choose which endpoints will perform discovery. For example, you might want to use only workstations that are fixed on site. Also, on the Exclusions tab, you can exclude specific IP addresses or subnets from probing altogether. Select Add Exclusion. Specify the IP address or subnet, and type a description. This is a useful way to exclude critical devices like honeypots, other security solutions that might misconstrue our scripts as malicious, or sensitive devices where probing could foul things up. We differentiate between private and corporate networks we've discovered, so we don't discover devices on private networks, like home networks. We use a lot of signals to tell us what type of network a device is on, like the quantity of devices on it as a percentage of the total and the name of the network. Of course, you can change each network's monitoring state on the Monitored Networks tab. It lists each network we found and its monitoring state, monitored or ignored. You can change this state by selecting Actions. For example, if we misidentified a network as corporate, change its state to ignored. Back to network devices, including switches, routers, WLAN controllers, firewalls, and security appliances, you can set up targeted assessments for these in Settings, Endpoints, Assessment Jobs. This will soon move to the Authenticated Scan tab on the Device Discovery page. There's some upfront work that needs to be done beforehand, though, like enabling read-only SNMP on network devices and setting SNMP credentials. You'll learn more about these requirements and find step-by-step instructions in the Docs page titled Network Device Discovery and Vulnerability Management. Once you've done that, you're ready to set up a targeted assessment. First, select Download Scanner to download the scanner. Then, install and register it on an endpoint that's onboarded to Defender for Endpoint and has connectivity to the targeted network devices. There's no need to overdo it here. One on each segmented network is fine. The last step is to add a network assessment job by selecting, well, add network assessment job. Type a name for the job. Select a device to perform the scan. Provide a list of IP addresses or subnets to scan and any credentials necessary for the targeted devices. Every hour, the scanning device will send SNMP queries to targeted network devices and send the responses back to Defender for Endpoint for analysis. And you see those results in the device inventory. So far, I've only covered network device and endpoint discovery. There's so much more to talk about though, including assessment and onboarding endpoints. I covered that in the next video, named Assess and Onboard Unmanaged Devices. Defender for Endpoint helps you to discover, assess, and remediate unmanaged endpoints and network devices. It gives you a clearer path towards a better security posture. For more information, we encourage you to see our documentation on Microsoft Docs.